Warm greetings to everyone present. I am gratified to be here with Joma and Rainer, virtually at least, and with Sunny in the second launch of our book, Reflections on Revolution and Prospects. I am very glad that our outfit, the International Network for Philippine Studies, decided to publish the book after my 2 months of scouting for profitable terms from some liberal or progressive foreign publishers, some of whom agreed to publish and distribute the book internationally, but according to a so much delayed production schedule that it would not have seen the light of day until early next year, 2021, at which time world events would have rendered prospects into history. But first, let me express my deep gratitude to the sponsors of this book launch, BAYAN-National, BAYAN-National Capital Region, College Editors Guild of the Philippines, University of the Philippines Academic Union, and Congress of Teachers and Educators for Nationalism and Democracy. Let me also express my deep appreciation to the book reviewers, the moderators, MCs, and the cultural performers, as well as others who helped in organizing this launch in Manila. It would be nice to have other book launches in other regions and provinces all over the Philippines. And last but not least, let me also express my deep gratitude and appreciation to all who have helped in the production and distribution of the book, in proofreading, content critiquing, commenting, and just plain reading the final typescript, and expressed their enthusiasm by encouraging us to publish the book as soon as possible. What else is there for an editor and publisher to be grateful for? Of course, the more book buyers, the better, to enable us to continue publishing progressive and revolutionary writings, expanding our reach and influencing readers, who in turn we expect to swell the ranks of revolutionaries here in our country and the world over, and thus bring us nearer to the ultimate goal of equality, justice, and peace. The organizers of this launch have asked me to give a background on the book, how the idea for it came about, when, why this format that seems to make it a sequel to the earlier Philippine Revolution, The Leader's View, and how is it that Professor Rainer got to be Joma's co-author as interviewer. Let me give you a deep international background that led to the writing of the book, Reflections on Revolution and Prospects, is born of a material and spiritual kinship that has developed through 50 years and I hope would continue through another 50 years, part of which I expect to become solely spiritual. Though aged over a decade and located worlds apart, Joma's and Rainer's kinship started from their being Catholic sacristans, the former in Cabugao, Ilocandia, in northern Philippines, and the latter, in his own words, in the plains of the Westphalian Munsterland, in the northwest corner of Teutonia, which of course means Germany, end of quote. Being aged over a decade apart, while Joma was already leading the National Democratic Revolution in his country, Rainer was discovering the ills in Teutonia and on his own rebelling against this, which brought him touring the world from Africa and on to Japan, and from there visiting the Philippines for an intended quick visit but being captivated to stay on, traveling the whole country and witnessing the first quarter storm, building close and lasting friendships with the revolutionaries who happened to be our own friends, among them the journalist hero Antonio Zumel, FQS martyr heroes Tony Tagamolila and Babes Calixto, who joined the revolutionary underground and died fighting enemy troops in the countryside, as well as so many other revolutionaries, now both living and dead, and not least, meeting at an opportune boat ride and wooing Marilu Ugalde Hardillo, currently his longtime soulmate and life's partner. In his Philippine stay, he encountered the various editions of Philippine Society and Revolution, therefore, how would he have missed it? Published and circulated widely since mid-1969, first in mimeograph form, serialized in the UP's Philippine Collegian, and after falling into the hands of the enemy military in a raid at the CPP production center in Capas, Tarlac in 1969, even in a mainstream national newspaper, the Philippines Herald, as an entire weekend supplement, all serving to inspire the FQS of 1970, and thus was Rainer convinced to translate PSR into his own language for his own people so that they may develop kinship and solidarity with the Filipino people, as well as further their commitment to their own country's revolutionary aspirations. Produced his German translation Philippinische Gesellschaft und Revolution, and had it published in May 1973. Rainer never met Joma in the Philippines, though there may have been times in his peripatetic existence there that he and Joma were within a kilometer of each other before the latter's capture in November 1977, followed by more than 8 years of detention until his release by Marcos's successor, Cory, thanks to the anti-dictatorship alliance having grown strong between the revolutionary forces and the anti-Marcos forces in the Philippines and abroad after the EDSA People's Uprising, and we were able to travel to Asia, then to Europe for an intended one-year world tour starting in 1987, that we finally met Rainer and Marilou in Osnabrück, Lower Saxony in Germany, where Rainer made his first long interview with Joma for a German publication regarding the current Philippine situation after Marcos, and where we also discussed the idea of him and Joma jointly writing a book, which later pushed the three of us, Rainer, Joma, and myself, to hie on to a Carmelite cloister house in Arnhem to discuss the book concept as a structured interview and begin the first stage of writing the book in early autumn of 1987, while Joma and I were waiting for the approval of our visa application to the U.S. for a series of prearranged lecture tours, which could have earned us some modest means to retire on for the rest of our lives, which never materialized, of course. Cloistered for a week in the suburbs of a famous location of a bridge too far for a failed Allied offensive in World War II, we earnestly hunkered down to work daily with my Sony tape recorder and Toshiba portable electric typewriter, a primitive precursor of a computer, gifted to me by one of our hosts during our earlier tour of Japan, taking breaks only for the free breakfast, lunch, and supper provided by our Carmelite hosts, for taking our turns in doing the dishes, and for Rainer's and Joma's cigarette breaks and me short walks around admiring the exotic plants and flowers in the small cloister garden, and also on the balcony on my way back to our workroom. Thus, when the 2 weeks passed, we had a sizable typescript for a book to be polished later after a two-week break from writing for Joma and me to attend and speak at priorly scheduled solidarity events and forums in the Netherlands, at which end the three of us would hunker down again to a week's routine of intense work producing a more or less polished typescript ready for translation into German at another religious house along Malisingel in Utrecht, the Nicolai Communiteit, again with our hosts providing us free board and lodging in exchange for doing the dishes. The first German edition of the book, Das Projekt Befreiung, Widerstand auf den Philippinen, Project Liberation, Resistance in the Philippines, was published in 1988, and the English edition, The Philippine Revolution, The Leader's View, a year later, by the mainstream US and UK publisher Crane Russack of the Francis and Taylor Group, followed in 1993 by the second German edition, this time under the title The Philippinische Revolution, Eine Innenansicht, faithfully adopting the German translation of the English title. And although I had put in much more time effort and energy in its making, including most of the editing of the English original. The book did not bear my name on its cover. However, the acknowledgement fully states my role in giving birth to the book. I've just given you a very extensive backgrounder leading to the production of the current book in English, Reflections and Revolution and Prospects, and in German, Ein Leben im Widerstand, Gespräch über Imperialismus, Sozialismus und Befreiung. A Life in Resistance, Talks about Imperialism, Socialism and Liberation, published simultaneously more or less 30 years later, and which, by the way, I had first proposed to Rainer when Marilu and he came to Utrecht for the 50th CPP founding anniversary on December 29, 2018, which at the time did not seem to interest him. But when it was his co-ex-sacristan who vouched the idea to him after my reminding him that the PRLV needed a sequel since three decades had passed, Rainer warmed up to the idea, and thus we had the pleasure of again working as a threesome, starting in the second week of February 2019. But this time, ping-pong style with Joma and myself together, and Rainer alone in the comfort of our own homes, through the World Wide Web within a span of some 9 weeks, after which I offered the publication again to Crane Rasak of the Taylor and Francis Group, thinking that they would welcome a sequel to the book they had previously published, but this time they were quick with a response that they do not publish the likes of the book. How times have changed in 30 years. A Filipino translation is forthcoming in March this year. Now that we have our own publication outfit, I hope and expect that our current book would be followed by several other translations in the major Philippine languages and further followed by a series of Joma's and Rainer's jointly authored books with me as editor, perhaps every 5 or 10 years to keep track of, analyze, and forecast world trends and events. And perhaps next time in reversed roles, Joma as interviewer and Rainer as interviewee. And Rainer, if you are listening, would you again protest and complain about being roused from your leisurely retirement, but then gladly embrace the idea of working with us in succeeding projects? Again, thank you all.